Hello everyone, my name is Sean and welcome to my channel where I talk about random language type stuff. While I'm busy learning Estonian, the winner of last week's SpeechLeech, today we're going to be talking about another language beginning with the letter E that didn't make it into last week's episode. What if I told you that there are real, actual breathing elves living amongst us? Or at least in a tiny forest village in the middle of Sweden. Without further ado, let me introduce to you the Elfdalian language, also known as Elfdalska. Deep in the forests of Sweden, in the province of Dalarna, there's a small locality called Elfdalen, which is where the English name Elfdalian derives from. They're not actually elves, unfortunately, but Vikings. Or are they? For centuries upon centuries, this area was very isolated, and to an extent still is, which is why the language developed very differently to standard Swedish. There was once a language called Old Norse, the language of the Vikings, which over 1,000 years ago began to diverge and change into the modern-day North Germanic languages, also known as the Nordic languages. Today, the 5 main official of these languages are Swedish, Norwegian, Danish, Icelandic, and Faroese. But other than that, there are literally hundreds upon hundreds of different regional dialects all over Scandinavia that differ from one another in pronunciation, vocabulary, even grammar. Elfdalian is technically one of these dialects, but it's so different from the others that it should be considered its own language due to the fact that it retained an unusual amount of old archaic features that have since been lost in other North Germanic languages. In turn, this has rendered Elfdalian completely unintelligible to speakers of standard Swedish. Actually, interestingly enough, vocabulary-wise, Elfdalian is probably closest to Icelandic, as this website points out, which is very interesting because it is usually Icelandic, the one language that is considered to be the most conservative and closest to Old Norse. Elfdalian might disagree. Which is why it is baffling to me and a lot of people in the linguistic community that the Swedish government, more specifically the Swedish Language Council, still do not recognize Elfdalian as a separate language, but rather just a dialect of Swedish. Like, look at this. There's this video by I Love Languages on YouTube, amazing channel by the way, where you can listen to Elfdalian phrases and words and it just being spoken in general. Just a quick look at the comments, you'll find people saying stuff like, "As a Swede, I understand at most one word per sentence of Elfdalian, Elfdalska, in the story of the Little Prince. From 120, I understand nothing. As a Swede, I understand less than 1% while looking at the Elfdalian text and listening. This is so incomprehensible, and I'm even from the same region as Elfdalen, although some 70 kilometers away." Let's now listen to a little clip of the beautiful language so you guys can hear it, and if there are any speakers of Swedish, and to an extent Danish, Norwegian, Icelandic, and Faroese speakers watching this video, let me know in the comments how much of it you actually understand.
I båten laset, båa ormers väger oversett helt. Outot et egget. Sen dåder ett bra ranger, och de sov om gäst månade och vända, mest det smält hjärta.
Come on, Sweden, hurry up and recognize it. You're being a real France about it. Anyway, as mentioned earlier, Elfdalian is a North Germanic language, officially considered to be a part of the Dalecarlian subgroup. That same name may be found in reading about the Dalecarlian runes, an ancient writing system used for Nordic languages centuries ago, which was gradually replaced by Latin pretty much everywhere, except for in Elfdalen. Dalecarlian runes were used to write Elfdalian up until the 20th century. How crazy is that? Nowadays, however, it's written using a modified version of the Latin alphabet. It's basically the same as the standard Swedish alphabet, except with a few extra letters. Firstly, there's a letter F, for the voiced dental fricative, which doesn't exist in Swedish and has been lost in pretty much all other languages descending from Old Norse, Icelandic being the only exception. Faroese has the letter, but doesn't have the sound, because why not? For reference, English has both the voiced and voiceless dental fricatives, both written as TH, and you can hear the difference when you pronounce the word th, this, and th, think, respectively. Then, Elfdalian also has these funky-looking vowel letters, and these are nasal vowels. Not even Icelandic has any. Elfdalian is the only Old Norse descendant to still retain this archaic feature, which is mad and really gives us a glimpse into the past of how the Vikings used to speak. That's all sounds though. If we take a look at the grammar, you can see even more clearly why it's completely unintelligible to speakers of Swedish. Swedish has 2 genders and 2 grammatical cases. Elfdalian has 3 genders and 4 grammatical cases. So not only will the words look, sound, and function in entirely different ways to standard Swedish, this may also influence the word order. The more cases, the more fluid it may be. In a nutshell, as this one Reddit user puts it, typologically, Elfdalian is pretty much as close as you can possibly get to a medieval Germanic language with actual living, breathing native speakers. They also included a link to some interesting lectures in Elfdalian, most of which are in Swedish, but I'm still gonna put a link in the description below in case you want to look at it. Now, unfortunately, Elfdalian is pretty endangered. There's a total estimated 2,000 to 2,500 speakers of Elfdalian left, of which, as some sources say, less than 60 are under the age of 18. Now, a few factors contributed to this decline in speakers. Firstly, the language was suppressed a lot during the 20th century. Just the usual no speaking it at schools and ridiculing children who do speak it, etc. It's sad. As linguist Yair Sapir explains it, many native speakers of Elfdalian, born before 1950, could not understand a word of Swedish before attending school. At school start, everything was suddenly in Swedish, and the use of Elfdalian was banned. This sometimes resulted in ridiculous situations, where Elfdalian-speaking teachers exclusively used Swedish with their Elfdalian-speaking pupils. Today, children who speak Elfdalian at home already speak Swedish at school start. Some of them quit using Elfdalian for good upon starting school, not to use active Elfdalian ever again. Secondly, we do live in a rapidly modernizing, globalized world, and you really can't be sitting in your little village your whole life anymore. If you want to do anything in life, du måste minst lära dig lite svenska, bro. Nevertheless, there are still plenty of preservation efforts. In 1984, the Organization for the Preservation of Elfdalian was established, called Ulumdalska. And then, in 2004, Rodjarum, the Elfdalian Language Committee, was established within Ulumdalska. Those are the guys and gals who also developed the alphabet, by the way. And there is also now a kindergarten which immerses children in Elfdalian, and there are many initiatives that encourage children to keep speaking Elfdalian all the way through high school. Ulumdalska even pledged to pay a stipend of 6,000 krones to any school children who can prove that they can speak Elfdalian fluently after 9th grade. There's also a lot of literature written in Elfdalian now. As mentioned in one of the YouTube comments earlier, The Little Prince was fully translated into Elfdalian. On top of that, Elfdalian is now in Minecraft. Yeah. You can go on Minecraft right now and play it in Elfdalian. How awesome is that? Honestly, say what you want about Minecraft, but it has been an incredible resource for language preservation. I've got a lot to say on this topic, more on that in a future video, maybe. Another cool fun fact, Princess Sophia of Sweden, a member of the Swedish royal family, actually grew up in Elfdalen, and her grandmother speaks Elfdalian, allegedly. But yeah, that's pretty much the story of Elfdalian. I'm sure I could have included a hell of a lot more, but as linguist Yair Sapir explains once again, what has been published about Elfdalian so far is almost exclusively written in Swedish. And I don't speak any Swedish. So the information that I had is pretty limited, and took a lot of perusing the interwebs. It's honestly hard to say what the future holds for the language. From an optimistic point of view, it'll probably survive in some households and small communities here and there for the decades to come, at least for sure, and I really hope it does. And honestly, I wish those people nothing but the very best. Everyone calls them elves, cause Elfdalian, and they live in the forest, but linguistically, they're actual Vikings. Would you rather be an elf or a Viking? In any case, I have to go back to learning Estonian. Till next week, peace out.